For a matched condition, and there's no reflection, ZL equals to Z naught. And to plot this load impedance, first we would normalize it. So to find little ZL, we would take capital ZL and divide by capital Z naught. This gives a value of 1. And since little ZL is equal to R plus JX, that means we have 1 plus J0. So first we have to find the R equal 1 circle. And that actually goes right here. You can see this circle is labeled 1. And when we have a real impedance, we're right on the horizontal axis. So we can see that this crosses right at this point. So at this point, we have ZL equals to 1. So the load impedance dot for a matched load is at the center of the Smith chart. Now I said we can obtain the reflection coefficient from the Smith chart. We know that when the load is matched to the transmission line, there is no reflection, and the reflection coefficient is 0. This means that an impedance dot at the center of the Smith chart must represent a reflection coefficient of 0. And we can see this on the Smith chart. There is a reflection coefficient magnitude scale on the bottom of the Smith chart. It's labeled REFL for reflection coefficient, E or I. Using this scale, what is the magnitude of the reflection coefficient for an impedance dot at the center of the Smith chart? Well, what we can do is we can draw a straight line down, and we can then read off where we are on the scale. So we see a magnitude of 0 here corresponds to the center of the Smith chart, and the magnitude increases as we move further away from the center of the Smith chart. Now that would be true no matter where we are, even if we're over here, because we would take the radius from the center of the Smith chart, and we would use this scale by going outward that same radius. Where then is a reflection coefficient of 1? Where would that occur on the Smith chart?